Now, a third major Philippine telco player moves a step closer to its commercial launch by clearing its first audit. The Philippine Competition Commission says Dito Telecommunity still has a lot to prove. Warren De Guzman with the full story.
The third major telco player, Dito Telecommunity of Davao-based businessman Dennis Oy and China Telecom, just passed its first technical audit. The National Telecommunications Commission said Monday a third-party auditor found that as of January 2021, Dito was able to cover 37.48% of the Philippine population. That translates to 37.8 million Filipinos in 8,860 barangays, based on 2015 census data. That is also slightly higher than the minimum coverage requirement of 30% of the population for year one. The third-party auditor found Dito did better on the minimum internet service speed requirement of at least 27 megabits per second. The minimum average broadband speeds delivered were 85.9 Mbps for 4G sites and 507.5 Mbps for 5G sites. The audit was supposed to have taken place mid-2020, but it was delayed by the pandemic. NTC Deputy Commissioner Ed Caballo says the next technical audit is set for July 2021. He says the commitments for this year are set at 51% of the population for coverage and 55 Mbps for minimum average download speeds. The Philippine Competition Commission says Dito Telecommunity still has a lot to prove during and after its commercial launch in March.
That it will allow not only consumers, but also micro, small, medium-sized enterprises to ride on this wave of e-commerce, that the digitization of the economy, which relies so much on telecoms, will be facilitated, will allow our small businessmen to actually use telecoms as a means to better market and distribute their services not only to the consumers in Metro Manila, but also in the far-flung provinces.
The PCC also notes that telecommunications is especially important to the economic recovery of the Philippines now that the pandemic has forced many businesses and households to go online for their daily needs. PCC Commissioner Johannes Bernabe says it is important for more players to enter the market to compete with Dito, as well as the incumbents Globe and PLDT Smart, to force them to improve their services. Bernabe says this is why the PCC continues to advocate for the easing of restrictions on foreign ownership in key sectors, including proposed amendments to the Public Services Act, which have been pending in Congress for years now.
The last mile would benefit a lot from investments which can come in from foreign capital, which not only complements the capital requirements of domestic incumbents, but would also provide the kind of technology that would allow us to jumpstart into the fourth industrial revolution and allow us to partake of the benefits of even better telecom services.
Trade Secretary Ramon Lopez says there will be other benefits as well.
Redefining public services through the PSA will open up public utilities and liberalize critical infrastructure and public utility sectors in the country, including ports, which would lead to improved supply chain and logistics. Given the high cost of logistics and the capital-intensive nature of the industry, allowing the entry of foreign companies in this sector would bring in new players, new technologies, and more competition.
That battle, however, is still in Congress. Dito's commercial launch is set for next month. Warren De Guzman, ABS-CBN News.